Well, in our continuing series this week, we take a look at how folks are spending their summer as we see all of these reopenings. One of the industries that was really affected last summer, of course, was the camp industry, day camps, overnight camps, over $16 billion in lost revenue last summer, and about 19.5 million kids who did not get to go to camp. So let's talk about what is happening this summer. It's looking a lot more open. Tom Rosenberg is the American Camp Association president and CEO. Tom, thanks for being here. So first of all, is it going to be all the way back to normal this summer? How many of those kids are going to be back? How much of that revenue is going to be back?
It's a great question, Julie. I would tell you that it's going to be closer to normal, but it won't be entirely normal this summer. We're still in our, this will be our second summer of COVID camp, right? And what we're going to see in all 50 states, we'll be operating day and overnight camps. So many more kids will get to go this summer than went last summer to day camp and overnight camp. But we're still going to see camps with slightly reduced operating capacity. COVID itself, the protocols that are necessary to make sure that we can mitigate the transmission of the virus at day camp and at overnight camp, those state rules or the CDC guidance may reduce the operating capacity of camps. So that's one challenge. And then the other challenge we're seeing is just there's a labor shortage out there for seasonal industries, and camp is not immune. So if we're not able to hire enough staff, qualified staff, then that might affect operating capacity as well. But on the whole, kids are going to have an opportunity, those that get to go to day camp and overnight camp this summer, all across our country, to have a joy of summer outside in nature, which is very COVID friendly. Kids are going to have an opportunity to meet, make friends, practice those social skills that they haven't really used as much in person in the past 16 months. And hopefully this will help them regain some of that humanity that was lost over the past year.
Yeah, my kids are going to camp, and we are all, as a family, very much looking forward to it. I do want to ask, though, before, and I want to get into the labor shortage as well, but before I do, how many camps didn't make it through the last summer? I mean, their business, obviously, for many of them, just completely shut down. Yes. Did they get aid, and what kind of closures did you see?
Well, I would say that the field of camp, is very wide and deep. Lots of different kinds of camps out there. But in general, camps, the field of camp is very economically fragile today. So many, like 82% of overnight camps did not operate last year, no revenue. And in fact, 40% of day camps did not operate. So PPP loans and economic injury relief loans were helpful. We're still looking for direct industry relief, looking for that to happen. It might still be coming. We hope so. The irony of all this is that this summer of all summers, right, and every summer to come, we need more camp, not less camp. Every single boy and girl in our country needs to have summer learning this summer and beyond to help them overcome what they've endured in this past 16 months. So we're seeing some camps that are changing hands. So some camps are closing, and we're trying to facilitate operators to purchase those camps so that we can continue to grow the capacity of the field. I would say demand is through the roof. The outlook for camp is very strong into the future, but it'll probably take the industry as a whole 3 to 5 years to regain some sense of normalcy. Most camps are cash starved and just doing everything they can to be prepared to operate as fully as possible, serve our kids.
You know, Tom, it's Miles here. As Julie mentioned, certainly labor challenges are seen across the country right now, particularly with hourly and part-time staff. And almost all camp staff is going to be some mix of one or both. What are challenges that you've heard from your members on trying to get enough people, usually high school, college kids, signed up to actually run a camp this summer?
Yeah, your typical college students, 18 to 25 year olds, I think they've also been through a really tough 15 or 16 months. Many of them who are in college, they're being asked by their colleges to take summer courses because they've had such a disrupted year. So they've got less time to work at camp. So we're working really hard as a field to try to fill the gap. Camps I'm talking to are telling me they're still down 5 to 10% in terms of labor. And so they're, we'll be recruiting qualified staff until the very last moment. And even after camp begins, I can see where camps will continue to try to rehire experienced staff who become available. I think, you know, for our college age listeners or viewers, working at camp this summer is probably one of the very best internships you can get. You're going to learn management skills. You're going to learn communication skills, problem solving skills, certainly conflict resolution skills. And you're going to have a great time making a difference in the lives of children. So it's a tremendous opportunity this summer. It does pay in most cases. Sometimes it's a volunteer position, but in many cases you're a paid employee and you're making good money, but you're having a lot of fun. It's very social. It's outside in nature and it's an adventure. So I think if, you know, for those people that are watching, if you're interested in working at camp this summer, we have a free website, jobs.acacamps.org. Go there, and there are lots of jobs available nationwide.
Tom, how much more will it cost to send two kids to camp this summer compared to last year?
Well, it's an interesting question. You know, what we're seeing, we're definitely seeing increased costs. So first of all, the number of participants is less than is not fully at scale. So the cost per participant is certainly higher than pre-COVID. So we're seeing, you know, we're seeing a range of, just pulling up some numbers here, you know, pre-COVID day camp ranged from less than $25 a day to over $150 a day, with a median of cost of $53 a day to parents. Overnight camps range from less than $50 a day pre-COVID to over $300 a day with a median of $110. Those camps that saw, you know, that operated last year had increased costs, reduced revenue, and they're trying to recover from that. But I don't think the market can absorb tremendous price increases. But the reality is, even without taking into account COVID expenses, the cost of insurance, for example, and the cost of staffing is definitely increasing considerably. And camp directors need to pass some of those costs along. So parents should expect to see an increased cost for camp for the foreseeable future. But the value of the experience, the value proposition for camp is greater than ever before. We have an entire generation of kids who have been, you know, traumatized, isolated, and, you know, they're ridden with anxiety and depression. They need to get outside. They need to be in highly structured educational and developmental experiences like camp, where they'll have an opportunity to try new things, restore some curiosity, reinforce growth mindset, and sort of regain those social and emotional learning skills that they so desperately need when they return to school in the fall.
Yeah, it's really interesting. If we see, you know, there's been sort of revaluing of the educational profession, and it seems like we'll see a commensurate re-rating or revaluing of the camp experience too.
Yeah, no question.
And hope. Tom, thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, I think that also it's worth noting that the American Recovery Plan Act includes funding for state educational authorities and local educational authorities to fund summer experiences like camp. And there's increased funding available for under-resourced families than ever before, because our government does recognize the need for this now more than ever. And it's really a three-year funding program. So I'm looking forward to seeing more collaboration between camps in local communities, parks and rec in local communities, after school in local communities, and schools in local communities working together, provide more experiential, kinetic, and hands-on learning for our kids outside in nature, when, you know, in the middle of this pandemic, when we know we can do this safely.
Definitely. Tom Rosenberg, American Camp Association President and CEO. Thanks for being here, Tom.